Hello and welcome to the first video of the chess programming series, in which I share a way of programming chess using Python and pygame. This video will cover how I went from an empty folder to making a functional local chess app. GitHub link is in the description. Let's start with creating a graphical user interface. Import pygame, alias it as D for draw to be shorter. Define init, which creates an 800 pixels wide and 800 pixels high window with its amazing icon and title. Init will also have a main loop running until user clicks the window quit button or presses escape on their keyboard. Don't forget to limit the frame rate of the main loop to avoid having your computer on fire. This function will need one parameter, an FEN string to start on a specific chess position made possible by this guy. Simply use the start position for now. This string will be converted by the string_to_list function to a list like this, with the current position, the number of moves played, which will be mostly used to know whose turn it is using the modulo operator, castling and ampersand rules, the number of moves without any pawn forward or piece captured to include the 50 moves rule, and 4 additional values for a visual effect of the last move played, currently only zeros. Y, or ranks, represent horizontal lines from 0 at the top to 7 at the bottom, and X, or files, represent vertical lines from 0 on the left to 7 on the right. The way I organize the values in this list is 100% arbitrary. This is still an empty window, so it's time to draw a chessboard with the pieces on it, using the fact that each square is 100 pixels wide and high. Define the drawboard function, whose goal will be this. Color the squares, light or dark, according to their sum file plus rank. Color the last move from the time white has made his first move up until the end of the game. I used John Pavlok's improved CyberNet chess set open game art link in the description. For each square, if the value of this square from our list is not a zero, put the matching piece on the board using pygame bleed function and adjust the position of the piece on each square to be at its center. By the way, using locals or globals to create 12 variables and link them to 12 images in just 2 lines of code, or more generally transforming a string into a variable name, saved me quite some time. This is what it looks like. This is all still immobile, so it's time to add user input using events. The main events will occur when we click on a piece or its square, when we drag the piece, and when we drop it on another square. Or when we just click on a piece or its square and then click on another square. After allowing pieces to go anywhere, these events will mainly need 3 other functions. First, when a piece is selected, we'll need a function to enable only the end squares allowed by the International Chess Federation for this piece. It will have 4 parameters: the custom list, the piece the player wants to move, and the X and Y of the square the piece was on when selected. Store the coordinates of every possible end square in a list. Here are the possible squares for pawns. For every piece from now on, we can use the eval function to avoid repeating conditions or operations. Here are the possible end squares for knights, bishops, rooks, and those for queens and kings. Now remove the coordinates of moves which are illegal, in other words, those which leave the king attacked. I used a simple function to find king's position as well. Then return the list. Second, we'll need a function that verifies if a square is in check, often king's square, to prevent illegal moves. This one will need 4 arguments: a custom list, the X and Y of the square that we're testing, and the color that wants this square not to be directly attacked. Put 0 for white and 1 for black. Code according to pieces capturing movements, starting with the knight, which isn't affected by enemy pieces blocking the way. Then pawns, queens, bishops, rooks, and kings. double the code for white and black. This might not be minimized lengthwise, so this will certainly be improved by the time of the next release. Return a boolean, telling if the square is directly attacked. Third, we'll need an aftermove function, which mainly handles ampersand, promotion, castles, and the possible ends of a game, checkmate or draw, either by stalemate, the 50 moves rule, or repetition of the position. Ends of game by time or agreement aren't included yet. This function won't return anything, but rather changes the state of the game. We can now add some functionalities to help any chess player see 130 moves ahead, including square coloring and arrow drawing, which code is quite chaotic and I couldn't explain. These will be included in the main loop as well as in the drawboard function in order to keep them visible when drawing multiple ones. So here's the release. Full code is available on my GitHub, link in the description. This program works, but is still only a starting point to what seems to be or become a very long journey of new ideas and commitment. So I'm going back to my code. I would really appreciate any feedback on the video, if I should explain deeper or make it more general, the color theme, the program itself, the flow, speech, actually anything that could improve this content or that you just want to share. Also, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comments. On these words, thank you very much for making it this far, and may your next hour be absolutely wonderful.